In this video, we will see ventricular volumes during a cardiac cycle. Let's get started. The volumes in right and left ventricles are the same. Values mentioned in this video are for one ventricle. This graph shows volume on y-axis. As we have studied in the video on cardiac cycle, the ventricular systole includes isovolumetric contraction, rapid ejection, and slow ejection. And diastole includes isovolumetric relaxation, rapid filling, diastasis, and atrial systole. We will start with the systole. By the end of the diastole, ventricular volume has reached the maximum. Now, first in the systole is isovolumetric contraction. During this, all valves are closed and there is no flow of blood. So, there is no change in the ventricular volume. At the end of the isovolumetric contraction, semilunar valves open and ejection phase starts. Initially, there is rapid ejection. So, initially, there is a rapid fall in the volume. Then the ejection gets slower. So, during this, the falls becomes less rapid. Then the ejection ends and semilunar valves close. This is followed by isovolumetric relaxation. During this time also, all valves are closed and there is no change in the volume. Now, the atrioventricular valves open and the filling of ventricles start. Initially, there is rapid rush of blood from atria to ventricles. So, the volume shows a rapid increase. Then, during diastasis, the filling gets slow. So, volume increase also becomes slow. Then, the atria contract. And this pumping increases the ventricular volume. This marks the end of the diastole. Thus, one cycle is completed. Next, there will be isovolumetric contraction and then ejection, which leads to a fall in the volume. The cycle is repeated. So, this is how ventricular volume changes during a cardiac cycle. Now, there are some important parameters regarding the ventricular volume. These are end-diastolic volume, end-systolic volume, stroke volume, and ejection fraction. Let's see them one by one. End-diastolic volume, as per the name, is the volume of blood in a ventricle at the end of the diastole. Naturally, this is the maximum volume that a ventricle achieves. Normally, it is about 120 ml in each ventricle. Then we have end-systolic volume. See, during systole, the ventricles do not get completely empty. Some blood is left in the ventricle at the end of the systole. The volume of this blood left in the ventricle at the end of the systole is called end-systolic volume. Normally, it is about 50 ml in each ventricle. Next parameter is stroke volume. It is the volume of blood pumped out by the ventricle during each systole. The formula for stroke volume would be stroke volume is equal to end diastolic volume minus end systolic volume. Normally, it is about 70 ml for each ventricle. Finally, we have ejection fraction. It is the fraction of end diastolic volume that is ejected during each heartbeat. Thus, ejection fraction is equal to stroke volume divided by end diastolic volume into 100. Normally, it is about 60%. That means, out of total blood in the ventricles at the end of the diastole, 60% is ejected during systole. So, this was all about ventricular volume during a cardiac cycle. Now, let's have a quick summary. During isovolumetric contraction, there is no change in ventricular volume. During rapid ejection, there is a rapid fall. And during slow ejection, this fall becomes less rapid. During isovolumetric relaxation, there is no change. During the rapid ventricular filling phase, there is a rapid rise. Then during diastasis, the rise gets slower. Atrial systole increases the ventricular volume. End-diastolic volume is volume of blood in the ventricles at the end of the diastole. And systolic volume is the volume at the end of the systole. Stroke volume is the amount pumped out by the ventricle during each cycle. And the ejection fraction is a fraction of end-diastolic volume that is ejected during each cycle. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.